Man, first of all, man, I'd like to welcome each and every one of you back to the Hot Shot Haven, man. I ask that you would please like, comment, and subscribe, man. We out here truck trapping, man, and this what it is. All your input, all the questions, comments, we most definitely appreciate it. All the shout-outs, all the contributions to the channel, man. Hey, I got to shout out one of the subscribers, man, that actually sent a donation via Cash App. You can most definitely do that at any time. Probably put the Cash App right there. You want to subscribe, I appreciate it. Click that bell for notifications. We're going to cover more videos. But the topic for today, like I said, was the comparison, man. Apples to apples, you know what I'm saying? Nothing funny. For the sake of argument, you know, we're going to do two very alike trailers, but yet very different trailers. First of all, we're going to come in with the Gatormade. Okay. Hey, man, 35-foot configuration. That's 30 plus 5, 30 foot of deck space, 5 foot for the mega ramps. Dual 10K jacks, dual 8K axles, 12.5 by 4 inch brakes on it, very large toolbox, extra lighting, spotlight included, and manufacturer retail price, I mean, out the door, tag, title, and everything, $11,500. The Gator, that's over there on in the blue corner. Now in the red corner, we're gonna take a look at the Diamond C. Also, 35-foot gooseneck trailer, 30-foot of deck space, 5-foot mega ramp. Hey, two 10K jacks. Now, this is a thing that we discovered during a very awkward moment where you don't want to really discover that this trailer doesn't have what you think it has on it. Well, they are dual 7K axles with standard 2x10, 2x12 electric brakes. And, let's see, doesn't have a light bar, does have ample storage, has a toolbox in the neck, also has an extra toolbox underneath the deck, which is a very good feature. Price out of the door, tag and title, about $11,500. So we're looking at, like, we want to say apples to apples, but a lot of people will say, nah, that's an engineer beam trailer, it's lighter, it's stronger. Oh, the Gatormade is just basically a square frame, triangulated type frame deal, and there's not any comparison in the two trailers. But if you know like I know, when it comes to spending your money, there's always a comparison to be made. And you know, like I said, I'm not here to down either one of the trailers. I'm not here to promote either one of the trailers. I'm here to just discuss some of the things that we've come to realize about these trailers in a very short amount of time. It don't take long. When you run like we run, and you put the miles that we put on, as fast as we put them on, things come up quick. You figure out what works and what doesn't work. Okay, first and foremost, the Gatormade over here in the blue corner, sitting over there sparring with itself like his name, Ali. Okay, one of the best things I can say about this trailer is it is built strong. It's a very strong trailer. It does not sag in the middle with loads on it. The way the trailer is optioned out factory with the axles, the spring pack, the heavy duty tires, 17.5 rubber, is a very stout piece of equipment. Okay? Very stout piece of equipment. Some of the things that I've noticed since I've had this trailer, it's been some small things. I ain't gonna say small or big. It's just been some things. Okay, first of all, the Gatormade tire upgrade, 17.5, 16 ply tires. On paper, that is a very good upgrade. It only comes to when you see it in person that you realize this tire upgrade is actually an upgrade to Thailand made, China made tires. that was one of my big gripes. I feel that a tire upgrade should indeed be an upgrade. I don't think you should just take 10 plies off, put on 14s or 16 plies, and not really have a quality tire and call it an upgrade, because it's not about the money. At that point in time, you need what you need, you want what you want, and whatever it costs, that's what you're gonna pay. So don't try to save me any money by getting all your tires from Thailand, because things like this happen while you're on the road. And it's not only dangerous, it costs time and money. I will say that Gator made actually put me in touch with the tire manufacturer who they carry their warranty through, and I was actually refunded the price of replacement on all four of those tires, because individually they all did the same thing. If you look at these pictures, that's not what you want when you're going down the highway with weight on you, especially with only four tires and not eight. You don't want that. Next, I had an incident really as soon as I got it with a brake on the trailer. That's why I say in my Indiana brake video about that scamming in Indiana, that it is a scam, because I've been through the complete system of the trailer already. This stuff has already been done, to the point where I had a problem with a brake maybe 2 weeks after ordering that trailer and getting it and bringing it home. I probably had ran maybe 2,500 miles, maybe 3,000 miles with the trailer, and the rear passenger side brake on the trailer began to make a noise. And upon further inspection, realized that the magnet had exploded inside of it, come apart, and was causing that brake to be inactive. So what I did was I ordered a whole complete brake, back and plate and all, shoes, self, never adjust, same one that came on there, specced on there, and I put it back. Also, I had an incident where it was completely my fault. I blame the state of Tennessee, but me as the operator, is my fault. I was pulling out of a gas station parking lot with about 7,000 pounds over the axle on the deck of the trailer, and it had been raining that morning, so you know, all the road looked wet. Well, little did I know, the area where the trailer would be tracking to get on the road, there was a 2-foot, I'm not exaggerating, 2-foot pothole. I don't know if you call that a pothole or a melting pot, or I don't know what you call that, a cauldron. I don't know what you call it, but it was a huge pothole. And when that trailer went down in it, the edge was basically 90 degrees with that tire coming out. And with the force that turning at about 15 miles an hour, it crimped that axle, that front axle of the trailer on the passenger side. It crimped it like it was made out of paper clips. So upon that happening, I immediately contacted GatorMade about that axle. Have not heard a thing. And I gotta say that their warranty sucks ass on just customer service. It really does. It's not good. If you want somebody to feel your pain when something happens to your trailer, Gator is not the person to do it. I went out of pocket and spent, I actually bought a tire and an axle, and they won't sell you a tire without a rim, so I got the rim and tire and an axle, and came on back about $1,650 lighter in the pocket, you know. And that's just what you got to do, because that trailer got to keep moving. We got loads to run. Okay, next, Diamond C. Gotta love that technology in motion, you know. As that you probably heard, the engineer beam, you know, that's a great feature. That deck has an arch in it that does not flatten out even under some of the most strenuous of circumstances. It's an extremely strong trailer. In contrast to the Gator, the Diamond C has lipid axles instead of Dexter. Most of all, the components are compatible. Have 2x12 brakes. Stops great. A little less longevity than you would like. And like I say, it's a great piece of equipment. It has the mega ramps that come out. They're double hinged, they're double assisted. It's a great looking trailer. It does the part in class, and it looks like style. When you pull up Diamond C on the side, they know that's a Cadillac, you know. And you know, that's one of the things that, you know what I'm saying, I say it's a Cadillac. Well, I work for GM, and just to be honest with you, Cadillac didn't get it right till probably about 10 years ago, maybe 13 years ago. They just started getting it right, and everything has flaws, and we can't say that. But when I say you pull up Cadillac, it could be a dual meaning. It could be you pulling up luxurious as I don't know what, man, the best of the best. Or I could mean you pulling up in something that probably won't last, like the fender tips on old Eldorados and the tail lights and the bumpers on old Eldorados just crumbling up and falling apart where the bumper filler goes in. But that's beside the point. One of the first things we noticed, and I say we because this trailer is operated by owner-operator out of the Illinois area up near Chicago. He sees some cold, he sees some heat, he goes where he has to go, he works very hard, and he spent his money. And like I said, both of these trailers are comparable in price. So when you got a guy that spent his money and he comes out and he does the best he can to get the best product possible, you can't fault him. But what you can fault is the manufacturer of this trailer. Now let me tell y'all something, man. Within 3.5 weeks of owning this trailer, we come to realize that, hey, we got some bolts under here dealing with the trailer suspension that aren't tight. I'm not gonna say not torqued. They're not tight. They're hand tight. They're finger tight. And the way we found out about this was coming through Louisiana, head through Mobile, got to Pensacola, Florida, whole axle came out of one side of the trailer. Leaf spring bolt, shackle bolt, whatever you want to call it, gone, missing. Not sheared off, not broken, just gone. If you know about these trailers, you do it in your own maintenance, you know all the shackle bolts, equalizer bolts, and things like that have a serrated nut that more or less boogers up the threads if you want to try and reuse that bolt, because by doing that, it creates a friction fit on the threads. So therefore, that is a locking nut. That nut locks, and I'm gonna drop a picture of it for you down up in there. That nut locks. So if it's ever tightened, even if it's not completely tight, it will not back off. And if you know how an equalizer and a spring works on a trailer, you know that is basically a through bolt. It's not necessarily squeezing anything. It's just providing a pivot point and somewhere for that bolt and for that spring to rest and pivot on. Okay, come find out, hey, that bolt ain't tight. It came out, axle just, whew, almost lost the whole axle away from under the trailer. Okay, that caused downtime, things like that. Okay, boom. Now, 2 or 3 days before that, you get a situation where over the course of 36 hours, same owner-operator lost 3 tires. I get up with him. He's got the upgrade also. 17.5 low boy tires, 16 ply, good tires, you know, on paper. Pull up on them, check it out, and look, you know, hey, we crisscross, so I run up on them sometime, and it's on purpose just to check in with my people and just make sure everybody good. And come to the realization that, oh, he got these Thailand-made tires too. Oh, God, they peeling off. They losing tread. They breaking belts. They wearing it regularly. Okay, well, hey, that's another strike. Okay, now, this is possibly 3 months ago when all that started, ending up with the axle coming away from under the Diamond C trailer, probably a month ago. That's February. Now it's March. We get up this morning, March. Driver does pre-trip as normal. does everything as normal. Checks his brakes, they're working as normal. Comes down 220, Jackson, Mississippi, not too far from my house where I was actually still at home because I had a late pickup to do on the load that I'm actually sitting there right now, still waiting on them to load me. But at the same time, took the opportunity to do this video. So, hey, he calls me, he's like, coach, what's up, coach? He called me, coach. Hey, coach, what's up, coach? Man, I just lost my whole tire, rim, tire, hub, everything. It came off the trailer and rolled down the embankment. I got to go back and unhook it and go try and find it right quick. Man, I don't know what's going on. I get over there, look at it. You know, before I looked at it, he sent me a picture. Let me put that up. Picture of what's going on. So I'm like, okay, that looks like a bearing is seized and everything, and it exploded and it came off. So I get over there. I notice, well, as soon as I look at it and look back at the picture, look at it, I said, man, like most of the whole braking system is missing on this thing. And the bearings, they're gone. The races are still there. On the good side, the threads weren't messed up on the castellated nut that goes on there or anything like that. So it was able to be rebuilt. So I looked at it. And upon further investigation, we looked at the drum that was still firmly bolted to the rim and tire. We unbolted it and noticed that the drum had split right down the middle in a horizontal way. So now there's only half a drum left and pieces broken God knows where. Came to the realization, brake magnet exploded inside the wheel from contact or whatever it was inside of there, and exploded, wedged itself between one of the brake shoes at high speed, and the drum exploded. It's not hard to figure it out. The drum exploded, which dislodged the bearings, which all that stuff is bolted to the hub and to the drum that rides on the bearings, and that center nut holds it all on. So once the races and bearings had been torn up, it was free to come off, and it did. It came off. It didn't hurt anybody, thank God. Nobody was injured or anything. And he called me, and about 30 minutes later, I was on the scene. And like I said before, we got together and spec this trailer, you know, for durability, and we made it a point to ask Dexter to upgrade the tires and the axles. Well, by me having a lot of 8K axle parts, seeing that I bought a complete 8K axle with springs and brakes and everything, and I just did some more maintenance on my trailer yesterday, I had bearings sealed, a new drum, I had everything that he needed. So I just packed all that stuff up in the truck and went out there to fix the problem. Lo and behold, when we get there, I look at this stuff, I look at the backing plate, it's 5 bolts on the backing plate. I said, that's not right. If you know how this stuff goes together, you know a 7K axle has 5 bolts in a star pattern, an 8K axle has 4 bolts in a slightly rectangular pattern, a 10K has also 4 bolts in more or less a slightly rectangular pattern, and the size of the bolts are completely different. 8K axle has much larger nuts and bolts than a 7K axle, and of course, by the brakes being a different size, they're only 2 inches wide compared to the 8K's 4 inch wide, the drum doesn't fit. So I get there and we come to the realization that, hey, there may have been a reason why that trailer we ordered was about 3.5-4 weeks late, and they kept stalling and this and that, and they ended up coming up with a trailer out of the blue in no time when they said yours was still getting built. It's because they may have, and I'm not blaming Dexter, it may just be what was a typographical error or something like that, but the tires were upgraded, but the axles weren't. Come to find out, I look at it, I know exactly what it is. I've seen it too many times. Even though it's a Lipper axle, most of the Dexter stuff still fits. And I looked at, that's a 7K axle, man. I call Alpha Trailer, shout out to them for being open up early and on time this morning, and got over there and bought a complete drum hub assembly with the bearing seals pre-greased and everything, and got it back over there. And about 15 to 17 minutes later, he was up and going, you know. And that's another one of my making money by saving money things, because this Noble Enterprise, we're a family. I ain't charge him a dime and would never charge him any money for to do any type of service like that on an emergency roadside type of thing right there. Because one of those things about it, if you wasn't in that situation and you needed help, you wouldn't call. So why would I step on your neck at the same time and charge when we got enough to worry about just with parts and all that stuff, man? I'm trying to help you have a better day. That's what I'm going to do as the coach, the professor, whatever you want to call it. That's my job, to make sure they straight. So we did that, got him on his way. He was headed to his delivery, has made that drop. Had to juggle around the next pickup, which was going to be today, but we got to move to in the morning. He's going to go hang out, you know what I'm saying, up there in Arkansas. Meanwhile, I'm in Arkansas. So there's some bumper heads crisscrossing and lane changing that I do that a lot of folks can't even do one way. I do it five ways, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, I do this every single day. And you know what I'm saying? And I ain't gonna say it's a solo, completely solo act, but at the same time, the responsibility falls on who is that responsibility on, and that's the owner. And I take that responsibility with pride, and I take it seriously. But yeah, back to the trailer. Okay, after that happened, you know, he's, like I said, he's all about his way and going about what he's doing. Now, on the Gator, the Gator trailer, I gotta say this, you know what I'm saying? I don't think it was a case of the 445 Friday build or anything like that with the Gator made. I've just come to see that some of the things that they use as far as parts and materials and somewhat of their powder coating process, that may not be the best, and that's true. And I have to say that other people have complained about the powder coating. Mine isn't doing very bad, but it's not doing super good either. You know what I'm saying? I've noticed that the Diamond C has tended to keep its luster a little bit longer than the Gator, but that still is up to be seen, because at the same time, every day keep going, we keep working these things. But like I say, two of the things that really jumped out from the standpoint of going from a person that's shopping to a person that owns one of these trailers, I'm not gonna say deceptiveness, but I will say this: the level of marketing that is done by both of these companies, and I'm not singling either one of them out, both of them market the way they market, they use their strong suits in their opinion. You know what I'm saying? And one thing I can say, Gator told me from the beginning, we don't make a lightweight trailer. Not doing what you're trying to do. If you want something real, real lightweight that'll do what you're trying to do, you know what I'm saying, you might want to stick with the PJ, or you might want to look elsewhere, get you a Big Tex or something like that. And they told me that, you know what I'm saying? So their thing was Gator made strong. You know, they never told me this trailer weighs 6,000 pounds at 35 feet. On the flip side, Diamond C's main argument when it comes down to picking their trailer over another trailer is that it's strong. Two things they say all the time: it's strong, 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 and lightweight. Lightweight. Diamond C, if you watching this, I beg to differ, man. Because, like I say, it's not so much as an apple comparison when you got two different kinds of trucks hooked up to them. But just for the sake of argument, we know what a 2019 GMC Duramax 2500 weighs, unladen. We know what that weighs. We know what a 2013, 2016, 2018, 2006, we know what those Dodge Ram 2500s weigh, unladen. So why is it that when I pull up on the scale with my 2013 Dodge Ram 2500 and my Gator trailer, it says I'm a little bit, just a hair, over 16,000. And that's with my auxiliary tank full, all my dunnage and everything, and an empty trailer. In comparison, the 2019 Duramax pulls up on the scale right at 16 and some change. Without an auxiliary tank, he has the dunnage, he has all his personal effects and everything like that, but to be honest with you, my auxiliary tank is mediocrely small. It's only 45 gallons, but that's all I really need. I don't need the extra weight just to go farther. I just like to go a little farther without a whole lot of extra weight. So you take into account that diesel is about 8 pounds or 8.9 pounds, somewhere around 9 pounds a gallon. We rounded up to 10. So if I put 45 gallons of diesel in that tank, I'm gonna multiply that and I'm gonna get 450 pounds. We know diesel isn't quite 10 pounds, so that'll be the weight of the tank itself. You know, it's easy math and we ain't gonna worry about what the tank weighs. Okay, now, somebody gotta answer this. Why is it that two trailers, same length, basically outfitted the same way, they have mega, both have mega rounds, both got 35 feet of deck space. One has an engineer beam, the other one has a regular I-beam type frame. And the Gator trailer has upgraded axles, which are heavier. And the Diamond C has an added toolbox, which is not heavy at all. Why is it that both of those truck and trailer combinations weigh the same? Virtually the same. It's less than 200-300 pounds different, to be honest with you. And I gotta say, that was shocking, surprising, disappointing, to say the least, amongst other things, when a person has gone out, spent their money, and they're trying to achieve a dual purpose. They're trying to achieve something that lasts a long time, get you longevity and value, but they're also trying to achieve something that goes below normal weight, so you can put more payload. More payload equals more money. And that's one of the things that shocked and surprised me about Diamond C. And it's not because I didn't expect a trailer of that size to weigh 7,000 plus pounds. I expected it. My trailer weighs 7,000 plus pounds. That Gator right there weighs 7,000 plus pounds. I know this. But why is the exact same trailer almost equipped equally, but the main selling point is lightweight? Why is it not lightweight? Amongst the things with the 445 on the Friday bill, where they left bolts and stuff loose under the trailer, and that was a serious hazard, could have cost some people their lives, property, and some more stuff. Man, the jury's still out on it with me, because to be honest with you, for what these things cost, you know what I'm saying, and what you have invested in it, I think a company should really take it serious. Not only how they treat an individual as a customer, but also how they treat their employees, how they motivate them to want to work, how they make the environment safe for them and make it so that they can do their job at the best of their abilities to provide usable, good products. The truth of the matter is, because we hot shot here in America, all of our trailers are American made. But to be honest with you, there are not a lot of things or companies that are still building stuff in America. So when we take time to support companies that are here in America and not go to Canada or Mexico and buy the cheapest trailer that we can, we expect quality. not only so much in the workmanship, but quality of the suppliers. Lippitt got a good name in axles. They had a bad day today. Dexter got a good name in axles. They had some bad brakes on the one they sold me. You know what I'm saying? And it's not about not making mistakes or errors. It's about how you recover and how you treat the customer. You know what I'm saying? And if it's somebody from Dexter that want to reach out to me because Gator may have not reached out to me, I'm going to do another warranty claim on that axle. You know what I'm saying? And if it doesn't go through, it doesn't go through. But at the end of the day, it was not overloaded. It was being operated in a safe manner and things occurred. So, you know, I'm not saying that it's justifiable for them to give me anything. I just would like somebody to address the fact that I even put in the claim. I haven't heard anything back from these people, period. And on my tire incident, it was over two months before I actually got a real actual answer about anything being even done about it. It got handled. I got to applaud them for that. It eventually got handled. But, you know what I'm saying, in the grand scheme of customer service, if I got a customer with a need and they come to me with that need, I'm gonna be expeditious about it. And you know, I'm gonna make it happen in a very timely fashion to let them know I really appreciate their being a customer. And the crazy thing about it, that alone, you know, and I ain't gonna say it cost them money, it did, but it, Gator, y'all can look at me in my face and just know one thing. Since I bought my trailer, that'd have been three more trailer purchases inside my company as a whole. And one thing about it, the only reason my partner went and got a Diamond C and owner operator and pulling that Cadillac like that, hey, he got him a Diamond C, the best thing he thought he could buy, you know, is because of y'all customer service. Y'all reviews on customer service, your paint work and yada, 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 it wasn't good. But I say your personal service was good. I enjoyed being a part of picking up the trailer and meeting everybody and all that stuff. But via the warranty department, via the service department, y'all different things like that. Hey, man, on the internet, far as Google is concerned, y'all not that good. And that's what made him decide to go buy a Diamond C. What made the other owner operator decide to go buy two PJs. What made the other owner operators decide to go buy a PJ. Now, they did that before I bought the Gatormade, but I was rocking with PJs, and they are still good trailers. And get what? Might see one return in a little while. We're going to get a little of everything going on around here. We're going to do some real long-term reviews. But I want you to know that the Gator is at about 60,000 miles right now. That Diamond C has less than 25,000 miles on it and has lost three tires and an axle and an axle again. It's I don't know. But I do know this, you know, there are ways to handle business, and we're gonna see how Diamond C goes about rectifying and making sure this is put to bed and made right for the owner operator, because we out here working hard. We out here keeping this thing moving, and whatever you can do to assist your fellow trucker, or whatever you can do to assist your fellow person that's trying to get this work out here, man, do it, and do it with a smile, man. Hey, this Jonathan bringing you more informative content. Like, comment, subscribe. The High Shot Haven. We're going to holler, man. Peace. Keep them wheels right side down and be blessed, man. Y'all be safe out there.